Alright guys, welcome back to the channel. I'm your boy, The Pinchy, and we're back at it with another video. Today, talking about the server merge and what is that doing to the community nowadays. So we're in 2023, we're in April, and so now we've had some months to see what the server merge did to the community. Let's talk a little bit about what actually happened with the merge. So back in, let me pull it up right here for Game King. It says, hello Tamers, this is Dat Center. It says, through the maintenance of the 20th of December of 2022, we are preparing to basically merge servers so that the Tamers can enjoy DMO in a more comfortable environment. So what they did is they scheduled a server. They did it in a couple of different updates since December of 2022. And it says right here, except for the Omega server, all servers, okay, we have Leviamon, Lilithmon, Barbaramon, Bolzevimon and Lucimon were gonna be merged into Alphamon, and so it actually used to look like this. Yeah, a lot of people don't actually know what it looks like now, what it would look like before the update, but there you go, you have all the servers, okay? So they all got merged, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, into one Alphamon server, and then Omega stayed the same. So the people that were in Omega stayed in Omega, the people that were in these five got merged together into one. So now, great idea. We've been talking about it for years, and I'm not even kidding you, for years. We'd be telling like Game King, come on, you gotta merge the servers. We have a lot of people that stop playing in this server and that server, but there's still some people that are still playing. Can we just merge it together? And they finally did. But here's the but. Problem is, you also region locked the game. And so before, the game was global. Okay, it was just called Digimon Masters Online. There was the Korean version, and then there was the global version. And it didn't really matter what your IP was, where you came from, you could play in that big, big, wholesome server for global. Now, it's separated. And so now we have like Latin America Digimon Masters, we have the North America Digimon Masters. And so what now, that's what's causing issues. And I'm gonna explain why in this video. The first thing is, for the people that live in the States, or if you're in North America, you have to understand a couple things. Digimon is huge in Latin America. I'm from Mexico originally, and I remember watching the show when I was a kid for years, and it was so much more popular than Pokemon. And I know that's hard to believe, but Digimon is huge, and you know it because I remember back in the day when we were playing in Global, you would have people speaking in Portuguese in the chat, and people would be like, oh, you should be speaking English. And it's like, no, like, you have no idea the amount of people from different countries in Latin America that want to play Digimon. You have people from Argentina, people from, you know, Venezuela and Peru and Brazil, people from Mexico. You have like Latin America is huge when it comes to Digimon. And the fact that it divided us between North America and Latin America is a big problem, because we're losing on a lot of people that play the game. And I get it, maybe it's a language thing and you wanted to make sure that people were playing with the same language, but we adapt. Like, I remember when I didn't know English, you still found a way to figure it out. And I just feel like, I understand where you were coming from. This was a great idea. You merged these five together into one, and that increased the playability a lot. It's been great this past couple of months, to be honest. Like, compared to how it was before, you know, playing it for 12 years, it's been great the past couple of months. There's still some issues, obviously, and if you haven't seen that video, we talk about it, you know, check it out. But like, it's been good, but they fumbled. They definitely fumbled. I do not like what they're doing, and I hear people from the Latin American side that they wish that we were still doing just global, and then that they merged the servers together and we have two now, you know? And I don't know if maybe for the remaster, they'll listen to us and they'll fuse it back together. I know that they probably did it because of certain laws, maybe, of how you can run things in different countries. Not really sure, but then the people that are in Latin America that want to play with most people, which is in the North American version, they have to use a VPN so they can transfer, you know, their location to somewhere else, so they can actually get, they can bypass the IP. But if they catch you, you get banned. So it's like, we got to talk about it a little bit more. I hope that you guys that are watching these videos can help me push this to the game masters and the community managers and masters, because we definitely need to fix this. I know for a fact that this would make the game much better. One of the other things that I didn't talk about the other video is this, the server merge and how it's affecting today. So hopefully they can listen to us a little bit. Let me know what you think. You know, maybe you disagree. Maybe you think it's good that we separated, even though, you know, there's people that don't like it. I want to hear what you got to say. Obviously, we'll talk about it in the comment section down below. But one thing is for sure, the server merge was a great thing. We just might have to tweak a little bit more, right? So thank you guys for watching. We'll see you guys in the next one. Take it easy and peace.